First off, what you're going to see the first time you see it, it looks different. It's a new visual scheme. They call it calm or calming. I don't know about that. It does look a little bit different, a little bit more organized. The start menu's different. It's not like we have now where you could resize it and you have live tiles that are flipping. It's not like that anymore. It's going to be right there in the center. You have a different start menu, but you've got some pretty cool productivity pieces that I'm excited about trying. One is called Snap Layouts. Now, a lot of you may understand, know how to snap a window in, a window in Windows. As you grab the top of the window, you drag it all the way to the right, for example, it lights up and you let go and you take another one, go to the left, and they'll be perfectly side by side without having to move them around. Well, now, currently with Windows 10, you can only do that side by side. You can't do it up and down, these sort of things. Now, with Snap Layouts, you can set up any sort of layout you want for these snaps. If you have one monitor, you want it to be side by side. The other monitor, you want your applications to snap maybe one in each corner, something like that. You'll be able to set that up. And that's actually pretty handy. I know if you haven't used the Windows Snap before in Windows 10, that's something you want to take a look at. It really helps me out because a lot of times I have maybe four or five programs open at once, and I'm always looking at email, right? So this is one easy way you can create a layout, a Snap layout, and put each one of those little apps in its little kind of window area where it lives, and then you'll be able to monitor it from there. So they also have a new feature that's called Snap Groups, and this is kind of an extension of the Snap Layouts idea. Now, what it does, it Windows remembers the apps you've been using and how you've been using them together. Like if Windows notices that you're using Outlook and OneNote at the same time all the time, then they're probably going to start making that a group. When you start one, you start the other. That's one thing. The logic is that when you're working on multiple programs, you're going to need multi-windows. So you're going to have these groups. So it just basically sets it up for you.